Logo Archive presents The Best of the Worst, the Golden Raspberry Awards. Welcome to the 2017 update to my top 25 list of the all-time Golden Raspberry winning movie studios. This list is calculated on a points-based system where one award equals 1 point. For the Razzie Redeemer Award, the distributor of the movie in which the actor redeemed themselves gets a 1 point deduction. This has led to a curious instance in my list where currently 4 movie studios are on minus 1. If you watched last year's video, then I'm about to say something that is quite strange. Don't bother watching this one. The rankings are almost exactly the same as the last one, and I'll tell you why as we go into the honourable mentions. The mainly Christian movie distributor Pure Flix distributed this year's worst picture, a documentary known as Hillary's America, The Secret History of the Democratic Party. Now, Logo Archive is apolitical and neutral, but it's not hard to guess why many critics in Hollywood might not have approved of a largely right-wing film. Nevertheless, it picked up 4 awards, meaning that more mainstream studios were left to pick up the scraps. Joint 23rd is Constantin Film, worst picture winner with the 2015 remake of Fantastic Four. Also at the bottom end of the top 25 are AMLF and Chagors, the two French companies co-producing and financing the horrific 1995 Showgirls. The only time that these two companies have gotten a Razzie Award, with 8. In the top 20 is Regency, whose worst picture winner was the 2001 flop Freddy Got Fingered, with 5 awards. Staying relatively put is DreamWorks, whose main offenders include Norbit in 2005 and the worst picture of 2009, Transformers Revenge of the Fallen. New Line haven't won worst picture, but Sex and the City 2 is probably the closest they've been. Moving on to M. Night Shyamalan's Blinding Edge Pictures, who single-handedly put it in a running for a podium finish this decade with The Last Airbender and After Earth. Hollywood Pictures, who won 2 Best Picture Awards, including Alan Smithy Presents Burn Hollywood Burn. Self-prophetic for the label, don't you think? And of course, the infamous Franchise Pictures, who produced Battlefield Earth, winner of 9 Golden Raspberry Awards. The only movie studio to have actually moved this year. Lionsgate picked up the inaugural Barry L. Bumsteed Award, an award which is for a movie that cost a lot and lost a lot. The Lionsgate premiere movie, Misconduct in Association with Grindstone Entertainment, won the award and therefore moved it up 1 place. Staying put at equal 13th is Summit Entertainment, who got the worst picture of 2012 with the Twilight Saga Breaking Dawn, winning 7 Razzie Awards. Also staying in its position, Carol Co. You wouldn't believe it, but Rambo First Blood Part 2 was mainly negatively reviewed by critics and picked up 5 Razzie Awards, including Worst Picture. Morgan Creek only made 2 Razzie winners. The first was Robin Hood Prince of Thieves, which got 2 Razzie Awards. The other was Battlefield Earth. Columbia's co-partner Revolution got 7 Razzie Awards in 2003 when they produced Gigi. Village Roadshow produced the 2004 Worst Picture Razzie winner, Catwoman, and picked up another swag of awards with Sex and the City 2. The Razzies hate Adam Sandler, so I'm surprised this production company is as low down as it is. Jack and Jill won 10 awards in 2011, a Razzie record. Meanwhile, United Artists haven't won an award since 1995. But their two main offenders include 1985's Rocky IV and 1995's Showgirls. Canon were infamous for bad movies in the 80s and have the third highest total of the decade. Their biggest offender was 1984's Bolero, winning 6 awards. MGM have 3 Worst Picture Razzies to their name, Inchin in 1982, Showgirls in 1995, and Basic Instinct 2 in 2006. Like the rest of the bottom half of the top 10, staying put at number 6 is TriStar, who've had their own fair share of bad films over the years, including 2007's I Know Who Killed Me, which won 8 Razzie Awards. Thankfully, it didn't kill the studio. As you'd expect, our top 5 is all full of major Hollywood movie studios. These studios are miles ahead of the rest of the list. Let's find out as we go to number 5. Staying at number 5 is 20th Century Fox, who've picked up 4 Worst Picture winners, including the most recent one, and have gotten the second highest Razzie total of the noughties. Paramount, who have gotten 5 Worst Picture winners, spanning from Mummy Dearest in 1981 to The Last Airbender in 2010. They also have the honour of having the equal third highest total of the 2000s. Universal have won Worst Picture 3 times, The Lonely Lady in 1983, a joint winner with Howard the Duck in 1986 and 50 Shades of Grey in 2015. Universal hold the infamous honour of winning 2 decades worth of Razzie Awards, with first places in the 80s and the 90s. Sony better be careful about putting their branding on Columbia and TriStar films. Columbia have also gotten 5 Worst Picture winners and hold the Razzie record for the most awards given in a year, when they distributed the Adam Sandler film Jack and Jill. They also have the third highest total of the 90s and the 2000s. Under the Cherry Moon, The Postman, Wild Wild West, Battlefield Earth, and Catwoman. Not to mention second place in the 80s, second place in the 90s, and winner of the 2000s. Need I say more? Unfortunately, it's a short logo, so I can't.